I got a clean bill of health here, folks. Nothing wrong with the Trump campaign. No collusion. I told you this all along. I won fair and square. Nothing about how he's responding to the attack on our democracy. And more importantly, not looking backwards, Brianna, but how is he going to prevent it from happening again?
Yeah, because this is about a bigger issue than just the president. This is about the country, Phil Mudd. So what do you think? I mean, what do you think about this?
Well, first of all, the document doesn't talk about collusion among Americans. It indicts 13 Russians and explains why they're indicted. By the way, did the president actually read this? One of the most striking elements of this is it comes out in black and white and says, before the election, this was specifically driven to favor one candidate over another. I don't know how you could read the document and not draw that conclusion. The last thing I'd say about what the president has said and what I draw from this document, he went on to make other allegations about the document. For example, it lets him off the hook. I mentioned earlier on the election and in other areas. Most of what he spoke about in his tweet, I didn't find in the document. I can't correspond what I read today in one of the most remarkable intelligence documents I've ever read with the president saying this doesn't indicate collusion. It doesn't address collusion. It addresses 13 Russians.
No, it's a really good point, Sean.
Yeah, I think it is. But, you know, when I look at these documents and I think about your question, you know, why is the president addressing this larger issue of what the Russians did? I think that if we can take a step back, I look at these things through a national security lens. Let's put the issue of collusion aside for a second. Maybe it happened, maybe it didn't, we don't know. Let's also put the issue of whether or not there was an impact on the election aside for a second. If we can just look at the fact that Russians, an adversarial government, came into our country, not just through digital means, but they physically came into our country to set up the infrastructure to allow them to attack our election process, then I think that all Americans can take a step back and look at that and say, we want to see the Russians held accountable for that. And the big question is, why aren't we seeing that? You know, we kind of get caught up in this whole issue of collusion and other things, but we need to just look at that fact from a national security perspective, because we're going into another election where they will do it again.
Because, Ryan, this is fascinating. When you read this indictment, they go to Texas, they go to Colorado, they go to Michigan, I believe, right?
Yeah.
They go to Virginia.
Yeah, and learn about purple states.
You know, that's right.
It started in 2014, and there's this sort of education process where they send these folks into the United States to learn about what's going on here politically. Now, frankly, I don't know if they needed to visit the United States to learn about purple states. In some sense, you know, it's not that sophisticated of an operation, but it is new and modern in the way that they use social media. I don't think...
Is it about learning how people organize and activate, though, on more of a grassroots level? Is that possibly what it was?
They learned to use the most salient fact about American politics against Americans, and that is the polarization and the cultural divide in the United States, and they learned how to sort of heighten the tensions. Now, let's be honest. This is not exactly new. At the height of the Cold War, the Russians were doing something similar in the United States by aligning themselves with certain activists in the 60s. It's not exactly new in this indictment about the nature of the Internet Research Agency and some of these things that we've learned about from other congressional investigations and what the intelligence community has said. What's new is a lot of new detail. And to me, what's really, really newsworthy today is the president's response, what
Sure.
you were talking about. Previously, there was a bipartisan consensus that this is an attack on our democracy and something needs to be done. What is new now is we have a president who doesn't believe that or doesn't seem to care about that.
And he seems to be really seizing on this idea that this exonerates him. It didn't affect the election. Now, that is not what the indictment says. So he calls it an anti-U.S. campaign. But I mean, as Phil said, did he read this? Because it gets to the point that as it did move toward the nomination of Donald Trump, this campaign coalesced around him.
Right. And it's not that he didn't read it. That may be also true here. But he misses the mark entirely, because the focus on idea of him being exonerated was not the issue of this indictment. It wasn't an ideological-based one about talking about the tenets of democracy. They actually pinpointed areas of the law that are already concerning: campaign finance, the ideas of money laundering campaigns and schemes, the ideas of using false identities to try to circumvent our reporting requirements, the foreign registered agent laws that are there. All of these remind you of things like Manafort and Gates and Michael Flynn and other things. You're honing in on what the logic is between Mueller's actual strategy. He's talking about sort of tenets of democracy, but in a larger legal sense, he's talking about why it is people can violate the laws and not have a particular impact on the election if that's the case. You can still violate it and endeavor to do so. And he's prosecuting those very crimes. You know, It's kind of a talking indictment, however, because he may not be able to extradite the people he's trying to condemn,
sure.
these 13 Russian, that Russian national.
He's not going to get any of these guys.
You don't think?
No, but what he's going to do is signal to the President of the United States this actually is, in fact, happening,
yeah.
to the congressional legislative committees that they can protect it and run in the midterms 2018. And also that, oh, by the way, the FBI is not engaging in partisan, hacked-based election investigations. They're talking about generalized democracy principles.
Laura, that last point is so important that you just made, because there's been such an effort on the part of the administration and some Republicans on the Hill to undermine the investigation day in and day out. What Rod Rosenstein did there today by going out there and presenting this, yes, they're not going to be extradited. We're not, you know, Putin's not going to all of a sudden send these folks over. But it totally bolsters the very basis of what this investigation is all about. And I think makes Donald Trump's job harder to seek to undermine it. I think that the investigation itself got a lot of political cover today from Rosenstein.
But Phil, it's been political for so long. I wonder after the special counsel taking so many hits politically, can this really assist, or is just some of the damage of politicizing this just so far gone?
I think it's far gone. One of the biggest losers in this case, in my judgment, is Devin Nunes. The effort on the House committee to undermine this investigation in light of what is not only an attack on election, one of the most striking parts of this awesome document, it's incredible, is the tail end that a lot of people will miss. These interventions into American politics, as you see in the document, continued after the election with an effort not only to favor one candidate, but to start putting out information like, for example, right here, not my president. After the election, clearly intended to divide America and bring American democracy to its knees, in my judgment, clearly also so Putin could continue interventions in places like Crimea. The fact that the Hill committees couldn't have a conversation about the hijacking of our democracy in the past year in light of this indictment, it couldn't be starker. Incredible.
What do you think about that?
No, I think...